Welcome to Grab and Go Info. Hierarchical topic models are the models that utilize the semantic hierarchy to identify parent-child topics for a collection of text. In this tutorial, we will use Airbnb review data to illustrate the following. How to use a transformer-based deep learning model to build a hierarchical topic model in Python. How to process the data to remove the noise in the topics. How to extract the topics and subtopics from the model outputs. How to make predictions for a new document. The Python package used for the hierarchical model in this tutorial is BERTopic. For more details about using this package, please check out my previous tutorials, Topic Modeling with Deep Learning using Python BERTopic, and Hyperparameter Tuning for BERTopic Model in Python. Let's get started. In step 1, we will install and import Python libraries. Firstly, let's import BERTopic. After installing the Python packages, we will import the Python libraries. Pandas and NumPy are imported for data processing. NLTK is for removing stop words. UMAP is for dimension reduction. HDBSCAN is for clustering models. Count vectorizer is for term vectorization. BERTopic is for the topic modeling. To get the code for this tutorial, please check out my blog post on medium.com. I will put the link in the video description. Medium.com is one of the most referenced websites for data scientists. It charges $5 per month for full access. I have been a Medium.com member for many years, and that's the best $5 I spent every month. If you would like to support me to keep providing free content, please use the link in the video description to join the Medium membership at no additional cost. If you prefer not to join, you can still read the post because there are a couple of free monthly posts for everyone to read. Okay, let's continue. The second step is to download and read the dataset. A website called Inside Airbnb had the Airbnb data publicly available for research. We used the review data for Washington, D.C. for this analysis, but the website provides other listing data from other locations around the world. Please follow these steps to download the data. 1. Go to http://insidearm.com/get-the-data. 2. Scroll down the page until you see the section called Washington, D.C., District of Columbia, United States. 3. Click the blue file name reviews.csv.gz to download the review data. 4. Copy the downloaded file reviews.csv.gz to your project folder. Note that Inside Airbnb generally provides quarterly data for the past 12 months, but users can make a data request for historical data of a longer time range if needed. Those who are using Google Colab for this analysis need to mount Google Drive to read the dataset. You can ignore the code below if you are not using Google Colab. Drive.mount is used to mount to the Google Drive so the Colab notebook can access the data on the Google Drive. os.chdir is used to change the default directory on Google Drive. I suggest setting the default directory to the project folder. pwd is used to print the current working directory. Please check out Google Colab tutorial for beginners for details about using Google Colab for data science projects. Now let's read the data into a pandas data frame and see what the dataset looks like. The dataset has multiple columns, but we only read the comments column because the reviews are the only information needed for this tutorial. The dataset has over 300,000 reviews. We read 10,000 reviews to make the computation manageable and save time for each iteration. .info helps us to get information about the dataset. From the output, we can see that this dataset has 10,000 records and no missing data. The comments column is the object type. In step 3, we will remove the noises from the top words of the topic model. There are three types of noises that impact the topic modeling results and interpretation: stop words, persons' names, and domain-specific words. Stop words are the words that commonly appear in sentences but have no real meaning, such as the N4. There are 179 stop words in the Python package NLTK. Persons' names are high-frequency words for Airbnb reviews because reviewers like to mention hosts' names in the review. Therefore, names are likely to become top words representing the topic, making interpreting the topics difficult. To remove the host names from the top keywords representing the topics, I downloaded the frequently occurring surname list from the US Census Bureau. It contains the first names with a frequency of more than 100. There are two columns in the US Census Bureau surnames frequency dataset. We only read the column name because only name is needed for the tutorial. After reading the names into a pandas data frame, they are transformed from uppercases to lowercases because the topic model uses lowercases. Two name lists are created using lowercase names. One list has the names, and the other has the name plus the letter S as the element. This is because a lot of reviewers mention the host's apartment, such as Don's apartment. The word Don's becomes Don's after removing punctuation. So we need to remove the name plus the letter S from the top words as well. Each name list has 151,671 names, and the top three names with the highest frequency are Smith, Johnson, and Williams. Domain-specific words are high-frequency words related to the business. For Airbnb reviews, reviewers frequently mention the word Airbnb, time, wood, and stay. Because I am using the reviews for Washington, D.C., the word D.C. is a frequent word too. Removing noises is an iterative process, and we can add new words to the list if they do not provide valuable meanings and appear in the top topic words. For example, some less common names such as Natasha can appear as top words. The word also appears in the top words too, but does not provide valuable information about the topic, so we will remove such words. To remove the noises from the top words representing the topics, we extended the stop words with the name lists and the Airbnb-specific words. After the extension, 303,529 words are excluded from the top words. In step 4, we will talk about how to build a hierarchical topic model. The hierarchical topic model produces results about the similarities among topics and helps us to understand the topic's subtopic structure. We will start by building a basic BER topic model. BER topic model uses UMAP dimensionality reduction. UMAP by default produces different results each time because of the stochasticity inherited from UMAP. To get reproducible topics, we need to pass a value to the random state parameter in the UMAP method. NNeighbors equals 15 means that the local neighborhood size for UMAP is 15. This is the parameter that controls the local versus global structure in data. A low value forces UMAP to focus more on local structure and may lose insights into the big picture. A high value pushes UMAP to look at the broader neighborhood and may lose details on local structure. The default NNeighbors value for UMAP is 15. N components equals 5 indicates that the target dimension from UMAP is 5. This is the dimension of data that will be passed into the clustering model. Min-dis controls how tightly UMAP is allowed to pack points together. It's the minimum distance between points in the low-dimensional space. Small values of min-dis result in clumpier embeddings, which is good for clustering. Since our goal of dimension reduction is to build clustering models, we set min-dis to 0. Large values of min-dis prevent UMAP from packing points together and preserves the broad structure of data. Metric equals cosine indicates that we will use cosine to measure the distance. Random state sets a random seed to make the UMAP results reproducible. Count vectorizer if for counting the word's frequency. Passing the extended stop words list helps us to remove noises from the top words representing each topic. In the BER topic function, we tuned a few hyperparameters. To learn more about hyperparameter tuning, please check out my previous tutorial Hyperparameter Tuning for BER Topic Model in Python. UMAP model takes the model for dimensionality reduction. We are using the UMAP model for this tutorial, but it can be other dimensionality reduction models such as PCA. Vectorizer model takes the term vectorization model. The extended stop words list is passed into the BER topic model through count vectorizer. Diversity helps to remove the words with the same or similar meanings. It has a range of 0 to 1, where 0 means least diversity and 1 means most diversity. Min topic size is the minimum number of documents in a topic. Min topic size equals 200 means that a topic needs to have at least 200 reviews. Top n words equals 4 indicates that we will use the top 4 words to represent the topic. Language has English as the default. We set it to multilingual because there are multiple languages in the Airbnb reviews. Calculate probabilities equals true means that the probabilities of each document belonging to each topic are calculated. The topic with the highest probability is the predicted topic for a new document. This probability represents how confident we are about finding the topic in the document. Using the attribute getTopicInfo on the topic model gives us a list of topics. We can see that the output gives us 9 rows in total. Topic minus 1 should be ignored. It indicates that the reviews are not assigned to any specific topic. The count for topic minus 1 is 2442, meaning that there are 2442 outlier reviews that do not belong to any topic. Topic 0 to topic 8 are the 9 topics created for the reviews. It was ordered by the number of reviews in each topic, so topic 0 has the highest number of reviews. The name column lists the top terms for each topic. For example, the top 4 terms for topic 0 are clean, neighborhood, restaurants, and bed, indicating that it is a topic related to a convenient neighborhood. In step 5, we will talk about how to merge topics manually. If we would like to manually pick which topics to merge together based on domain knowledge, we can list the topic numbers and pass them into the merge topics function. In this example, we merge topic 1 and topic 5 together because they both talk about breakfast, and merge topic 0 and topic 7 together because they both talk about neighborhood restaurants. We can see that the number of topics is reduced by 2, and we now have 7 topics. In step 6, we will talk about how to extract topic hierarchy from the topic model. After finishing building the basic BER topic model, we can extract the hierarchical structure using hierarchical topics. The output is a data frame with 8 columns. Parent ID is a new topic ID created for the parent topics. Parent name is a list of top words describing the parent topic. Topics is a list of child topic numbers included in the parent topic. All the child topic numbers in this column are from the basic BER topic model. Child left ID is the left child topic number. This child topic number can be from the basic BER topic model or an existing parent topic number. Child left name has the top words describing the left child topic. Child right ID is the right child topic number. Similar to child left ID, this child topic number can be from the basic BER topic model, or an existing parent topic number. Child right name has the top words describing the right child topic. Distance shows the distance between the left and right child topics. In step 7, we will take a close look at the topic hierarchy and create a mutually exclusive mapping between the parent topics and the child topics. Using topic model.visualize hierarchy, we can visualize the hierarchical structure of the topics. Hovering the mouse over the black dot shows the top words for the level of the hierarchy. Another way to visualize the topic hierarchy is to create a topic tree using topic model.getTopicTree. This view lists the topic representations for all hierarchy levels. After examining the topic hierarchy, we decide to create 4 parent topics. Parent topic 1 is about breakfast. It includes child topic 1 and child topic 4. Parent topic 2 is about the neighborhood with a focus on restaurants. It includes child topics 0, 2, and 3. Parent topic 3 is about the apartment itself with comments on the bathroom. It includes child topic 5. Parent topic 4 is about the stadium. It includes child topic 6. A function called topic mapping is created for the mapping between the parent topics and the child topics. In step 8, we will talk about topic model and sample hierarchical predictions. Firstly, we get the predicted child topic numbers from the BER topic model. Then, a column child topic is created in the data frame. After that, the topic mapping function is applied to each child topic number, and the parent topic column is created. The first review in the dataset says Don's apartment is comfortable, clean, and well-equipped. 3 minutes walk from the metro, wonderful terrace view of the river and Washington Monument. All in all, a great experience. I would certainly recommend Don's apartment to friends and would be very happy to stay there again. It is a good match for the parent topic too of recommending the apartment for the neighborhood. Using value counts, we get the frequencies of the parent topics. We can see that most reviews are about the neighborhood and a lot of people care about breakfast. In step 9, we will talk about making predictions for new documents. Suppose there is a new review, I like the apartment. The bathroom is spacious and clean. We can find the topic that is most similar to the review using find topics. The result shows that child topic 5 is the topic that is most similar to the review. The corresponding parent topic is 3, which is about the apartment itself. If you have made it this far, you probably find the information in this tutorial helpful. Please click the like button and subscribe to the channel to get notified when I publish new videos like this. To learn more about natural language processing, please click the YouTube playlist on the screen now. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video.